गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट, दिस इज़ अवर क्लास 5, सब्जेक्ट साइंस ईवीएस, टर्म 3, चैप्टर नंबर 5, नेचुरल कैलेमिटीज़ एंड अवर रिस्पॉन्सिबिलिटीज़। दिस इज़ अवर लेक्चर नंबर 2 प्लस समरी लेक्चर। स्टूडेंट्स, इन दिस लेक्चर वी विल बी डिस्कसिंग अबाउट रोल ऑफ इंडिविजुअल ड्यूरिंग नेचुरल कैलेमिटीज़ एंड रोल ऑफ द कम्युनिटी ड्यूरिंग नेचुरल कैलेमिटीज़। Student, in previous lecture, we discussed about different types of natural calamities. Our today's topic is role of individual during natural calamities. What we as an individual can do during natural calamities. Students, these natural calamities are not under our control, but we can help the people suffering from these natural calamities. We cannot control the force of nature or stop natural disasters. These natural disasters or natural calamities are not under our control. We can't stop them, but we can help the victims and reduce their suffering. We can reduce their suffering by donating blood, by donating money, food items, clothes, blankets, and utensils. We can provide medicines to the victims. We can also donate tents which provide temporary shelter to the victims. By providing temporary tents which will give temporary shelter to the victims, we can help people suffering from natural calamities. We can help the rescue workers. What are rescue workers? Workers which help during natural calamities. We can help by helping the rescue workers, by contacting the friends and relatives of the victim. We can console the rescue people and provide first aid to them. We can console. Console means sympathy. We can provide sympathy to the people and can also provide first aid to them. During natural calamities, we must cooperate with the police in maintaining law and order. We must make sure that antisocial elements are not robbing or damaging the property of the affected areas. Means we can provide help to the police by maintaining laws, and we can also make sure that antisocial elements are not robbing or damaging the property of affected areas. Student, there are also group of many peoples which work during natural calamities. NGOs are one of them. Okay, our next topic is role of community during natural calamities. What role does community do during natural calamities? Okay, there are many organizations and self-help groups which work during natural calamities. NGOs. NGOs mean non-governmental organization. It is an organization. It is a group of people which work voluntarily, means without any fee. They are providing help to the natural calamities sufferer. Okay. There are many natural organizations working for the betterment of the community. At the time of any natural calamity, they play an important role in providing relief to the victims. Student, NGOs are the non-governmental organization which help the people suffering from natural calamities. Okay, they provide relief to the victims. How they provide relief to the victims? They organize concerts and exhibitions to collect funds. Okay, they also create an awareness among the people about the miseries and suffering of the victims. Student, these NGOs collect donations of money, food items and clothes and send the same to the affected people. These NGOs collect money, food and items and donate to the affected people. Students, besides NGO, there are many other organizations like self-help groups. Self-help groups, what are self-help groups? Self-help groups is the group of the peoples of the affected areas which work for the betterment of the sufferer. Okay, these self help groups work during natural calamities. Okay, they help in maintaining law and order. They organize relief camps in tents, school buildings, temple complex. Okay, what self help group does? They help in maintaining laws and order and organize camps in tent, schools and buildings. Some doctors and engineers, bankers, teachers also provide help to the sufferer by conducting free consultation to the victims and helping them by donating money to build their homes. Student, next is Red Cross Society. What is Red Cross Society? It is a group or organization. It is a governmental group, okay, which works during natural disaster. It works during natural calamities. How does it help? It helps people by providing medical help. Under these societies, doctors, nurses and other people look after the sick and wounded people. Students, besides governmental and non-governmental organization, there are many organizations at international level which work during natural calamities, like UNICEF, World Health Organization, UNESCO. These are the international organizations which provide help to the victims of the natural calamities. Our armed forces like Army, Air Force, Navy, they also provide good help to the sufferers during natural calamities. Community participation at the time of disaster is very important. Student, we the part of the community should help the people during natural calamities. Our participation is very much important. Student, I hope this lecture is clear to you all. Let us have a quick revision. In first lecture, we studied about natural calamities. What we studied, that natural calamities are the events that take place naturally and cause great damage to human life. Under this, we studied that earthquake. Earthquake is the sudden shaking of the surface of the earth, which is caused due to collision of the plates under the surface of the earth. We studied that an earthquake of magnitude 7.3 hit Japan in 2013, which destroyed water supplies, roads, railways and communication, and lakh of the people were injured. We studied that Japan is one of the countries which mostly suffer from earthquake. Under earthquake, we studied about the seismometer, which is an instrument which measures the intensity of the earthquake. It determines whether the earthquake is major or minor. Our next topic was drought. A drought is a condition of shortage of water. It is a severe severe scarcity of the water, due to which cracks develops under the soil, because of which cultivations of the crops decline. And why this drought happen? It happens due to less rainfall, due to which land becomes unfit for cultivation. Next, we studied about flood. Flood is a condition when the level of the water increases due to heavy rainfall. Why this flood happens? It happens due to heavy rainfall or melting of the glacier due to global warming. Lakhs of the people get submerged when flood comes. Their properties, their cattle, they lose their even crops. Next, we studied about cyclone, which we called as Chakravat in Hindi. It is also known as typhoon in Japan, and in US, United States, we call it hurricane. What are cyclones? These are the fast moving, circularly moving, fast wind storms, okay, which hits the coastal areas with high speed and damage, and causes huge damage and brings lots of water along with high tides. Next, we studied about volcanoes, which are like a hill from which molten lava, which we call it as magma, comes out, and the opening through which this magma comes out is known as vent. What are volcanoes? These are hill-like structure which erupts and give out hot molten lava. Next was tsunamis. What was tsunami? Tsunami was is a condition, it is a series of very fast moving huge waves. These are the waves, huge waves or huge tides, which can reach up to the height of 30 meter and cause huge destruction. Why this tsunami happens? It happens when there is sea volcanic eruption. When volcanic eruptions takes place in the sea or earthquake takes place in the sea. Next topic was epidemic. What is epidemic? Epidemic is a condition where some disease spread very quickly and affect or infect thousands of people at that same time. Diseases like tuberculosis, malaria, cholera, dengue, these are the example of the epidemic diseases which infect thousands of people at the same time. And corona, which is a very serious problem nowadays, is also an epidemic disease which spread very quickly and infect thousands of people at the same time. Under role of individual during natural calamities, we studied that what we as an individual can do during natural calamities. We can donate money, blood, money, food items, clothes, blankets and utensils to the sufferer. We can donate tents which will provide temporary shelter to the victims. We must cooperate with the rescue workers. Okay, we must contact the friends or relatives of the victim. We can provide sympathy to the rescued people and can also provide first aid to them. We should also cooperate with the police during natural calamities for maintaining law and order. Under role of the community during natural calamities, we studied that there are a group of peoples which works during natural calamities. They work for the betterment of the sufferers. NGOs were was one of the organization which worked during natural calamities. It organized concert exhibitions to collect fund. They create awareness among the peoples about the sufferings of the victim. They provide sympathy to the people suffering from natural calamities. These NGOs help in maintaining law and order. They also organize temporary tents, schools, buildings and shelter and temple complex to provide shelter to the needy people. Our doctors, engineers, bankers, teachers also provide free consultation to the victims. Red Cross Society is also a governmental organization which provide medical help to the sufferer. Under this, many doctors, nurses provide free help to the sick people and provide first aid to the people. Our government also help the orphan children by providing them homes, by providing them funds. They also provide job to the needy people. Besides this, we studied that some other international organization or international agencies like World Health Organization, UNICEF and UNESCO. These are non-governmental organization. These are international agencies which also provide help to the sufferer by providing funds. Student, I hope this lecture is clear to you all. Let us do solutions of the homework 1. First question was, define natural calamities. Natural calamities are the events that takes place naturally and causes huge destruction. What are natural calamities? These are the events that take place naturally and causes huge destruction. Next question was, what is the cause of the earthquake? Earthquake is caused due to collision of the surface of the plates. Our next question was, what is seismometer? It is an instrument used to measure intensity of the earthquake. It measures the intensity of the earthquake. It finds out whether the earthquake is major or minor. Our last question was, which states are mostly affected by drought? Which states are affected by drought mostly? These are Rajasthan and Bihar. These two states often suffer from drought. Now student, your homework is question number 1. What help individuals can provide during natural calamities? What we as an individual can provide help during natural calamities? Question number 2. How different community can help during natural calamities? Under this, you have to write what are the different communities and how they provide help to the natural calamities sufferer. Thank you so much, dear students. I hope this chapter is clear to you all. And please write the answers of this question and give it to me on my mail ID. Thank you so much.